talking with this sir.
Let the IGP speak.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. And as a co-commander, 15th Corps has already given the brief of today's operation. I'll add that both the killed militants were notorious and important in a way that they had established their strongholds in certain areas due to coercion and threatening and so many other things. So it had become imperative to neutralize them in the interest of peace and in the interest of safety of general masses. So today, as the co-commander has already said, we received information in the wee hours of the morning about their presence. And one thing which we did today, we tried and tried hard to make them surrender. Announcements were made from masks, and we tried to utilize the services of the house owner and the persons who came out of the house to impress upon them to surrender. But because of Dujana's presence, the other fellow could also not surrender. And ultimately, you know what, when it is like that, it's like that. They started firing, and the quantum of fire from their side was very heavy today. It was retaliated, and both were neutralized. After the operation was over, properly the bodies were identified. And one was Abu Dujana, and the other one was Arif. So it was a clean operation, but for a civilian casualty of Firdos Khan of Begumbagh, and around 5 to 6 injured, pellet injuries and 2 bullet injuries. Initially, as it happens, in spite of our warnings and in spite of our requests, the people, on the behest of militants, I have been repeating it in every press conference, the people on the behest of these militants, maybe coercion or threatening, they tend to come in between the operating parties and the militants, and that's how they get injured or killed. Today also it happened in the same manner, and we lost a civilian's life. Regrettable, but it could have been avoided if the people stay inside and let the security forces do their job. These things won't happen. I'll take this opportunity and again appeal to the people, because the operations will carry on. Pelting or no pelting, disruptions or no disruptions, the operations will go on. Whenever we get information of militants, armed militants rather, in a house or in any area, the operations are to be launched. And yes, we are trying that they surrender, but if they don't surrender and they start firing on the forces, the only reply is to retaliate. That's what is being done. And co-commander has already mentioned about the activities, nefarious activities of RF, weapon snatching, looting, then killing of Sarpanch. If you remember, there was a killing of Sarpanch. It was which area? I think Pulwama.
Yeah.
Yes, he was involved in that. District president. Then Dujana.
Now, Dujana. Sarpanch Fayaz Ahmad Dar had been killed by Arif Dar.
Arif Dar. And Dujana, you know, he had become more a nuisance in the area by way of, I don't want to use those words, he had become an eyesore for everybody, especially the girls in the area. It was his sweet will now to enter any house and do whatever he wanted to do. Good riddance that way. I think people should relax, the girls, our sisters, they should relax now, that no such persons will be there to harass them anymore. Thank you very much.
Sir, talking of this operation, Abu Dujana, he's been active from the last 7-8 years. and probably mastermind and executor of several attacks on the security forces. So in that way, can we safely say it's a big dent to the operational capability of Lashkar, keeping in mind how he was involved in all these incidents and operations?
Yes, it's a big dent on the capability of Lashkar. Abu Dujana, but in his operational capability in the last 1 year or so, what we have seen, he was not involved in too many operations. Like the IGP mentioned, he was more of a nuisance. He was more involved in coercion and not many in terms of terrorist acts. So he was more of only enjoying himself here. Jisko hum kehte na ki wo ayashi kar raha tha yahan par. He was largely only a nuisance. That's the way I look at it. But the leadership of Lashkar-e-Toyba has been affected. And we, of course, will now keep hunting for the other leaders in this area. And our aim is to keep clearing them out as soon as possible.
So talking of the fallout, as you rightly said, you said that people should remain indoors, but they still come out. One civilian has been killed. We heard that internet services have also been snapped, if that's correct. So how do you see the fallout, and are we geared up for the fallout?
We have to be careful, because the number of militants is high, still high, and they use people to act in all these activities. Internet activities have been suspended for some time, and they will remain suspended for some time, because we don't want people to misuse the internet services and indulge in propaganda which is not called for. So we'll watch the situation, deal with the situation as it emerges, and I hope, and with the cooperation of people, we'll be able to set the things right.
So,
how long is it going to take the security grid to neutralize the militants, or to their bit?
We are doing our bit. It can't be in a time frame. We cannot give any time frame. Right. So it all depends on the quality of intelligence we get. So whenever we get good intelligence, we'll operate. So there can't be any time frame.
So my question to Mr. Raju, sir, is there any headway on Lieutenant Omar Fayaz's case?
Yeah, firstly, we are tracking the people who are involved in this particular act. And as you've seen in the last 2 to 3 months, the rate at which they're able to neutralize the terrorists, so it's only a matter of time that the perpetrators of that heinous crime will also be brought to book.
Sir, there were reports that Abu Dujana over a period of time had been in a way disowned by the Lashkar, or he was not in very good terms with his higher command, especially in Pakistan, and there were other commanders who were propped up. Who next, as far as Lashkar is concerned, on your hit list?
That is a question for which you'll have to use the option phone a friend. Right?
Who next, sir? Who next?
Every militant next. उधमपुर हमले में उस जमाने में अबू दुजाना, अगर आपको याद होगा तो लश्कर का एक इस्माइल से ज्यादा वो एक्टिव था, तो हो भी सकता है.
Right, sir. And what about the Amarnath Yatra attack? Any headway in the
investigation? Of course, a positive headway. We have been able to neutralize, to crack the case and neutralize all the OGWs involved in that case. Now we are gunning for the militants who were directly involved in the action.
OGW network has been smashed.
Yes, it has been smashed. They're all with us, and they are singing.
Vehicles
have also been seized, and everybody is singing. No problems.
Sir, are they only from the South Kashmir,
these
OGWs?
In that particular case, yes, from various places from South Kashmir. Yes.
So, what's the number of the OGWs that?
Can't divulge.
We'll leave something for your next press conference.
You should.
Yes,
should.
In fact, thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
तो सेना का ये प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस और जिस तरह से ये पूरी घटना को अंजाम दिया गया, इस कार्रवाई को अंजाम दिया गया, उसके बारे में सेना ने प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस के जरिए बताया कि किस तरह से ये आतंक का पर्याय बना हुआ था. अबू दुजाना के मारे जाने की पुष्टि इस कॉन्फ्रेंस के जरिए, प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस के जरिए।